Jesus Christ was beaten, mocked, and misunderstood. He endured the cross and despised the shame. Though the King of Kings, he was persecuted and died for our sake.
In this world we will face tribulation, but you promise you'll be right here with us.
And he said to his followers, if they persecuted me, they will persecute you also. And to this day, all over the world, they still do.
Nothing can separate us from the love of Jesus. If our God is for us, we are not alone.
But Jesus promised more, that those who suffer for his name's sake would not be forgotten, not by God, and not by the family of God. The Voice of the Martyrs was founded by a persecuted Christian as well. Richard Wurmbrand reached out for Christ to the Nazis in the early 1940s when they came into his native Romania. He felt a calling to reach out to atheists for Christ. He prayed for opportunities to share Christ with the Russians as well. And when the Soviet communists entered into Romania in 1944, they came right to his doorstep. Richard boldly witnessed to them as well. And just as Jesus promised, they hated him for it. He was arrested and sent to prison for a total of 14 years, often in solitary confinement, often tortured. Through it all, he held on to his love for God and committed to witness for Christ in word and deed, even to his torturers. In 1967, Richard, now free from jail and out of Romania, founded an organization committed to sharing the stories of others who, like him, were being jailed, persecuted, tortured, or killed for their faith. He often quoted Hebrews 13:3, "Remember those in prison as if you were in prison with them." That organization today is operating in 68 countries around the world, in regions that are dangerous, in countries that are restricted, reaching out through persecution response, through Bible distribution, and through frontline ministry. That organization is committed to stand with their persecuted family by saying, we will not let them suffer in silence. We will not let them serve alone.
From the love of Jesus, if our God is for us, we are not.
That organization, the Voice of the Martyrs. We will share their stories. We will mobilize the body of Christ to stand together with our brothers and sisters who face persecution wherever it happens. We will serve our persecuted family through practical and spiritual assistance. And we will carry on the mission of the one who called us, Jesus Christ, who said, "Go and make disciples of all nations, no matter the cost."
Welcome to A Bible for Every Believer, a global concert event featuring Keith and Kristyn Getty in partnership with the Voice of the Martyrs. Right now, in many parts of the world, Christians are facing persecution for doing some of the same things we're about to do: singing praise to God, reading the scriptures, sharing their faith in Christ. The Voice of the Martyrs exists to provide spiritual and practical support to those remarkable believers. Tonight, our goal is to focus the world on the need to get a Bible into the hands of every believer living in hostile and restricted nations. Throughout this program, we'll share how you can be part of fulfilling that amazing vision.
Hi there, everyone. We're Keith and Kristyn Getty, and we are huge supporters of Voice of the Martyrs. In recent years, as hymn writers writing hymns that teach the Bible to churches around the world, we've had the privilege of getting to partner with them and call them our friends. And tonight we're excited both about this huge opportunity at this unique juncture in time but also have the chance just to get to lead you tonight in your homes to sing along with these hymns.
Isaiah 40 says, "The grass withers and the flowers fade, but the word of our God stands forever." And we have realized more than ever in these last months just how fragile we are and how we are to cling to those things which are eternal, to God's word. And what an opportunity we have to share that with people who have yet to read the good news of the Lord Jesus. And now to lead you as you sing, that we share this hope that is the only hope for the world.
In Christ alone, my hope is found. He is my light, my strength, my song. This cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears are stilled, when striving cease. My comforter, my all in all, here in the love of Christ I stand. In Christ alone, who took on flesh, fullness of God in helpless babe, this gift of love and righteousness, scorned by the ones he came to save. Till on the cross, as Jesus died, the wrath of God was satisfied. For every sin on him was laid, here in the death of Christ I lay. There in the ground his body lay, light of the world by darkness slain. Then bursting forth in glorious day, up from the grave he rose again. And as he stands in victory, since Christ has lost its grip on me, no fear in death. This is the power of Christ in me. From life's first cry to final breath, Jesus commands my destiny. And no power of hell, no skin of man, can ever pluck me from his hand. Till he returns or calls me home,
One of the names behind me on the Martyrs Memorial is the name William Tyndale. If you read the Bible in English, like I do, you owe William Tyndale a debt of gratitude. But did you know that he paid with his life for translating the Bible into English? It was the 1500s, and translating the Bible into the language of the common man was considered heresy. In fact, in 1536, William Tyndale was burned at the stake for the crime of translating the Bible into English. Among his last words was a prayer, "Lord, open the King of England's eyes." And 3 years later, God had answered that prayer, and the king ordered every printer in England to print the Bible in English. So we have the Bible today in English. In fact, I have multiple copies, multiple translations in my pocket on my phone. But what about our brothers and sisters in hostile and restricted nations? What about them having access to the Bible? Here at the Voice of the Martyrs, we believe that every believer living in a hostile and restricted nation should have their own copy of God's Word. And we don't think that's a fantasy or a pipe dream. That's a concrete goal that can be achieved in our lifetimes.
You probably have a Bible within steps of you, or access to the Bible on your smartphone. Unfortunately, many persecuted Christians have no access to the Bible. For more than 50 years, the Voice of the Martyrs has been serving persecuted Christians. Their first request to us is for prayer. Their second request is send more Bibles. We are committed to getting a Bible to every believer in our generation. We invite you to sponsor Bibles right now. There's information on the screen for you to give. And during this program, a generous donor has come alongside the Voice of the Martyrs and is matching Bibles. So every gift you give has double the impact.
Where shall I go from your spirit? Or where shall I flee from your presence? If I ascend to heaven, you are there. If I make my bed in Sheol, you are there. If I take the wings of the morning and dwell in the uttermost parts of the sea, even there your hand shall lead me, and your right hand shall hold me fast.
When I fear my faith will fail, Christ will hold me fast. When the tempter would prevail, he will hold me fast. I could never keep my hold through life's fearful path, for my love is soft and cold, he must hold me fast. He will hold me fast, he will hold me fast, for my Savior loves me so, he will hold me fast. Those he saves are his delight, Christ will hold me fast. Precious in his holy sight, he will hold me fast. He'll not let my soul be lost, his promises shall last. Bought by him at such a cost, he will hold me fast. Christ will hold me fast. Justice has been satisfied, he will hold me fast. Raised with him to endless life, he will hold me fast. Till my faith is turned to sight, when he comes at last, my Savior loves me so,
Let me share with you one of the stories of one Bible that was delivered by the Voice of the Martyrs last year. This particular Bible was an audio Bible loaded on an MP3 player and delivered in southern China. An evangelist was working in that area, and he led a man named Xi to a personal relationship with Jesus Christ. Now, Xi had a very interesting story. He's from an ethnic minority group in southern China, and as a teenager, he was involved in a motorcycle accident. Because of his injuries, he lost the use of both of his legs, so he can't walk and he can't work. His wife has to take care of him, and they have two sons. But Xi came to faith in Christ, and this church planter gave him an audio Bible on an MP3 player. He said, "Listen to the Bible to help you grow in your faith." And Xi began to listen, and Xi began to grow in his faith, and God began to do something really remarkable. Slowly, over time, Xi began to gain strength in his legs. He began to gain some mobility. Now, Xi had a friend named Yang. Yang was 18 years old, and he had been born unable to walk. His legs were malformed. And Yang looked at Xi, and he saw him gaining strength in his legs, and he said, "What's happening? What are you doing?" And Xi said, "Well, I'm a follower of Jesus Christ, and I've been listening to the Bible. Why don't you take my MP3 player and you listen to the Bible too?" And so Yang took that MP3 player and he began to listen to the Bible himself. And you know the stories that Yang heard as he listened to the Bible. He heard stories of Jesus telling the lame man, "Rise up and walk." And so one day Yang told his mom, "I want to walk." Now, I can imagine Yang's mom saying, "Well, I want you to walk too, but you were born this way. You can't walk. You've never been able to walk." But Yang said, "I want to walk." And so his mother went and got him a pair of crutches. And Yang got up on those crutches and took the very first steps that he had ever taken in his life after listening to that audio Bible. I'm happy to tell you today, Yang is a follower of Jesus Christ. His mom is a follower of Jesus Christ, and lots of other people in that village who know his story, they're following Jesus Christ as well today because of one audio Bible delivered in southern China. That's one Bible in China. Think about the Bibles that are being delivered on helium balloons into North Korea, or strapped on the back of a donkey to smuggle across the border into Syria, or on a motorcycle riding into the highlands of Vietnam, or smuggling through the internet into Iran, or on a memory card hidden in a phone in Somalia. Each of those Bibles is a story of a life being changed. We talk here at Voice of the Martyrs about a Bible for every believer, and we talk about that happening in our lifetime. I hope that you'll join us to see more Bibles go out and more lives being changed. William Tyndale prayed that God would open the King of England's eyes. Here at Voice of the Martyrs, sometimes we pray that God will close the eyes of border guards and customs officials when we're carrying Bibles into these countries. A Bible for every believer in our lifetime. Join us to make that a reality.
The testimony of the Bible's impact on Xi and Yang was only possible because a Christian like you sponsored Bibles. No road is too difficult, no risk is too great when our brothers and sisters are crying out for God's Word. Any gift given to sponsor Bibles during this program will be doubled because a generous donor has agreed to match. Take this opportunity and have double the impact on these Christian believers around the world. You'll bring joy on their faces as some of them get God's Word for the first time. You can be a part of that. And as they grow in Christ, they'll reach others with the gospel. And then we'll need more Bibles to get into the hands of those believers. Be a part of what God is doing around the world and advancing the Great Commission by sponsoring Bibles. Your impact will be doubled through a generous match. Take this opportunity. The information's on the screen.
seed of Israel's race, ye rocks them from the fall. Hail him who saves you by his grace, and crown him Lord of all. Hail him who saves you by his grace, and crown him Lord of all. Woo!
What love the Father has lavished upon us that we could be called children of God, for that is what we are.
All-knowing, he counts not their sum, thrown into a sea with that bottomless shore. Our sins, they are many, his mercy is more. What patience would wait as we constantly roam? What Father so tender is calling
this song be a prayer for each one of us.
What grace is mine that he who dwells in endless light called through the night to find my distant soul, and from his scars poured mercy that would plead for me, that I might live and in his name be known. So I will go
is calling me. I lose my life to find my life in Him. I give my all to gain the hope that never dies. I bow my heart, take up my cross and follow Him. What grace is mine to know His breath alive in me? Beneath His wings, my wakened soul may soar. All fear can flee, for death's dark night is overcome. My Savior lives and reigns forevermore. So I will go wherever He is calling me. I lose my life to find my life in Him. I give my all never dies. I bow my heart, take up my cross and follow Him. I bow my heart, take up my cross and follow.
We invite you to be a part of our Bible distribution efforts around the world. A generous donor has come alongside us and has agreed to match every Bible sponsored during this program. So if you give to 5 Bibles, it will put 10 Bibles into the hands of our Christian family. Take this opportunity and have your impact doubled by giving a gift to Bibles. Sponsor a Bible now. The information's on the screen.
To hear the crying for life and love.
untire from cowardice, defend us from lethargy. Away, forth on thine errand, send us to labor for thy sake. And we go to all the world with kingdom hope unfurled. No other name has God to say but Jesus Christ the Lord. And we go to all the world with kingdom hope unfurled. No other name has God to say but Jesus Christ the Lord.
Thanks for joining A Bible for Every Believer, a concert by Keith and Kristyn Getty to make Bibles available to persecuted believers worldwide through the voice of the martyrs. Placing a Bible in the hands of every Christian believer is a task the global body of Christ can accomplish in this generation. At the voice of the martyrs, we are committed to a Bible for every believer living in countries where Christians are persecuted for their faith. And we need your help. $6 delivers a Bible into a hostile and restricted nation. Could you sponsor one Bible, or five, or 10 or more? With the help of Christians like you, we can make sure every Christian in a hostile or restricted nation has his or her own Bible. At the Voice of the Martyrs, we believe no road is too difficult and no risk is too great when our brothers and sisters are crying out for God's Word. Call to make your gift by phone, or go to the website right now to give online. What story will be told through all eternity about the Bible you gave to our persecuted brothers and sisters?
Time is short. Life is fragile. The urgent need to build deep believers is so great in the world around us.
Announcing Sing Global. An immersive digital conference connecting families, pastors, and churches, and encouraging deeper congregational worship.
Burst into song. And if you're looking for something to sing about, always sing about Jesus.
Join believers from around the globe as we focus on the centrality of God's Word in our worship worldwide.
This is the purpose of our salvation, for the sake of His praise among all the peoples of the world.
Featuring music led from all six continents with over 100 speakers and artists, four nights of plenary sessions, 40-plus breakout sessions, special seminars, and behind-the-scenes artist interviews, all available for 90 days so you can experience it all. Featured speakers include Keith and Kristyn Getty, John Piper, Johnny Erickson Tata, John Lennox, Trip Lee, Andrew Peterson, David Platt, Alistair Begg, City of Light, and many more. Sing Global, August 30th through September 2nd, and available online for the following 90 days. For more information, visit GettyMusicWorshipConference.com. Sponsored exclusively by Christian Healthcare Ministries.